Hello everyone and welcome to Simulink tutorial videos. In this video tutorial, I'm going to talk about how to build a model that represents a simple harmonic motion in Simulink. So in order to do that, we will consider an example of a person trying to bungee jump. So when a person bungee jumps, he is tied to a cable which has an elastic constant. That is done so that when the person is at the deepest point of his fall, he doesn't feel that jerk because of that cable that is attached to him. And to make that motion smooth and comfortable, an elastic cable is attached to that person. So the person, when he's at the deepest point of his jump, he'll go up and down quite a few times, and then he'll rest in one steady position. So for building this model in Simulink, we'll have to represent that same system using system equations, and which can be derived by representing that model in a form of a block diagram. So consider a cable that is connected to that person bungee jumping is represented by this spring, and the mass of that person is represented by this block called M. Now M is the mass of that person, and the spring will have a spring constant called K. So when that person has jumped, he will be acted upon by a force of gravity. So I'm going to represent that force with mg, which will act in the downward direction, and there'll of course be a restoring force that will be acted upon because of the spring that is present, which will have the value of minus kx. And now this x is the displacement that the mass will undergo while it is in that up and down motion. So this will be the value of x. Now in order to represent the same system using equations, let's equate all the forces acting on that object. Will be given by F is equal to minus kx. Now this is the restoring force that is acting upon on that object, and we know that object is also under the force of gravity, so this force can be equated to mg. So the equation turns out to be something like this. Now we know g is the acceleration with which the body is falling down. So this acceleration can be represented by the term x double dot. So the equation turns out to be something like this. Now representing this equation only in terms of double dot of x will be something like this. And this is the equation that we will be implementing in Simulink. Now, moving on to the Simulink model, I'm going to keep that equation on the right side of the screen so that you can see it. Now, I have already built a model which represents the same system. As you can see, we are going to need a double dot x, which is here, a single dot x, which is a velocity of that person or that object at a particular time, and this is x, that is a displacement. So we will be observing the displacement of the system. So this displacement, as the equation says, x double dot is equal to minus k by mx. This is the value of constant or gain that is represented by this gain block, which will be subtracted using a sum block, and that will represent our system. So moving on to the Simulink model, we see that the system is implemented according to the system equation, and you see the value of k is 300, that is the spring constant. Let's see what happens. Before simulating the system, we will obviously have to determine or specify the initial condition. Now we have defined the initial condition as 0.5. If we state it as 0, that means the system is already in equilibrium and it doesn't need a restoring force to get it back to its original position. But our initial condition is 0.5, we can change that value to, let's say, 6 or 5. And once that is done, we can simulate the system. So this is the output, and as you can see that the initial displacement is phi, and there is a continuous restoring force that is acting on the body to bring it back to equilibrium, that is represented by 0. So this is how you simulate such a model in Simulink. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to hit the thumbs up button or subscribe to keep yourself updated with our channel. If you have any queries or if you have any suggestions, please don't forget to leave it in the comment section down below. And thank you for watching this video. Bye bye.